Hello, captains. This is the Doctor, and guess what time it is? It's season 12 time. That means we've got a brand new featured episode to play. This is Of Signs and Portents. This takes place after the... Let's go to New Frontiers. This takes place after Echoes of Light. If you have not played Echoes of Light, go play it first or watch that video. I've got a video to this video that I have played. I will put a link in this video so you can watch that video before watching this video, if you would like. But the new mission we're going to play now is the new featured episode series of Signs and Portents. Remember, you get 400 vouchers, 7th anniversary prize vouchers, for playing this mission first.
The Lucari have discovered some unusual activity in an unexplored region of the Alpha Quadrant. The data suggests another weaponized use of protomatter, similar to what happened recently at Draconis 3. The Klingons have sent a ship out to assist with a Lucari investigation there, and we'd like you to join them. If the Zenkethi are involved, we need to know about it fast.
Ooh, travel to the Haranzi system in the Alpha Quadrant and investigate protomatter activity. So, we're going to get this Harbinger title, we're going to get the weekly reward, which is a tech upgrade or a specialization point, dilithium, 400 vouchers, a Braden reconnaissance deflector array, we'll look at a little bit later, more rewards to come, we've got an impulse engine, we've got a covariant shield, we've got two traits, space or ground, that will come in subsequent weeks. That means a lot of replay value for this mission to get all of the items. This deflector is part of a set called the Braden Reconnaissance Technologies set. So, you have to be in the Alpha Quadrant for this, and I am very close to some suns. We need to go to the Haranzi system, so let's do that. Never heard of this system before, never been there before. This is brand new. Title of this is Breadcrumbs. So let's see what happens. Remember, we found... This is the mystery, right? We found these huge protomatter crystals on 20 Draconis in the last mission, Echoes of Light. We found, like, it's almost like they worshipped this protomatter stuff, these alien creatures where Starfleet had visited them, the officers from K-13 hundreds of years ago. But for some reason, they had this vault of protomatter stuff. Why? Why? There was no answer to that. Maybe we'll get an answer here, but that remained a big question in that mission, and I'm wondering what the connection there is, because they did not ever explain that, so I don't know what's going on. Perhaps this is what will introduce us to the Zenkethi, so let's find out. Now, if you're wondering, by the way, I am on a science character playing as a science career. This is the Doctor, my primary character. I am flying, by the way, just so you know what I've got here. I've got the Temporal Science Vessel Tier 6. This is the 26th century Temporal Science Vessel. It's a very tiny ship, but as you can see, I got it maxed out with temporal powers. I've got the whole temporal set on here, the Temporal Reputation set. Totally maxed out on this thing. Also on myself, I am also using the Temporal Defense Initiative ground stuff as well. So totally maxed out on temporal technologies using all of that. So let's see what happens. Very, very excited for this mission, by the way, to see where this goes. All right, we've arrived in the Haranzi system. I'm reading two ships in space. Incoming hail from the IKS core.
Guavan. I am General Rodek, security advisor to the Lucari. I have read your report on the incident at 20 Draconis. If the Zenkethi are behind all this, we must be ready to meet them in battle.
We've got General Rodek. Now, if you're not familiar, this is Tony Todd doing the voice acting. Very, very well-known actor. So there you go. That is actually him. Agreed, the Zenkethi are quite formidable.
Do you have any questions?
Well, let's see. Why are you here?
I have met the Zenkethi in battle many times. I know how they think and how they fight. Because of this, I've been assigned to investigate the proto-matter incidents here. The Empire wants to know more about the Zenkepi's new weapon.
I see.
Do you have any questions?
What have you learned so far?
We know the Zenkethi have developed a proto-matter weapon. What we do not know is why. They have not attacked any of our enemies with this weapon. This is puzzling, considering their proximity to several key Federation systems. The Empire has asked, what drives the Zenkethi to use such a weapon? And I intend to provide the answer. Do you have any questions?
First of all, I like how the Federation and the Klingons are, like, working together now. It's like we're best buds, you know? After the whole Iconian War thing, the Klingon Empire and the Federation, I mean, we're buddy-buddy. We're doing everything together now. We're friends. We're very good friends, apparently. Let's get started.
The Lakari are just ahead and eager to begin the search.
Okay. It's rendezvous with the Lakari. The LSS Raskava. Raskava. Is this one of those new triangle ships? Yes, it is.
Good to see you again. It looks like we have another incident to study. We sent out a number of long-range sensor probes to this sector recently. After the events of 20 Draconis, I took the liberty of setting the probes to scan for protomatter. I'm afraid they found something. Let's begin our search by sending a short-range probe to the nearby planet.
This is your ship's maiden voyage, isn't it?
Yes, the project was a community effort designed by some of our best and brightest. With the help of our allies in the Alliance, we were able to finish construction and the shakedown cruise faster than anyone expected. The Raskava may not be as large or impressive as some ships, but she's ours, and she's ready for the job.
Congratulations, Captain. She's a fine vessel. And she will be mine very soon. I will have your ship. I will have your ship now.
The crew of the Raskava stands ready.
Okay.
Protomatter is the weapon of a coward, but we respect its power.
She has a high pulse
strength. Protomatter can also be quite beneficial, General, when used properly.
92, almost 93,000 hull. She has a very high hull strength. I mean, that is a very high hull strength for that ship. Look at that. It's a proper UFO. I want that so bad. All right, get into the planetary range and launch probe. Okay, let's do that. So the Zenkethi have pretty much mastered protomatter. They use it for good, not for bad. It pretty much powers all their stuff. There goes me probe.
The probe is away. The atmosphere of the planet is so thick it will take the probe some time to get through the interference. While the probe is busy, we can collect data from the planet's moons. At least one moon has signs of protomatter energy. A closer look will give us more information.
Sure, why not?
Perhaps the probe's information will give us more insight as to why these attacks are occurring.
Scan moon.
Most curious. This is a Class Y moon. It's incapable of sustaining most known life forms, but it was scorched by protomatter recently. Why would anyone devastate such a place? I think we should take a look at the next moon.
Well, I'm gonna guess as a testing ground. I mean, if it's uninhabited or whatever, wouldn't you... You could use a moon to test. I bet they're building
perhaps
some kind of...
use the moon as a test site for the weapon.
You're catching on. I'm thinking maybe they're trying to build some kind of planetary-wide
weapon. It was a poor choice. Why scour a world already devoid of life?
To test the weapon.
It sickens me to see protomatter used like this.
They're making weapons, duh. It's what they're doing. It's kind of self-explanatory.
Another enigma, I'm afraid. This is a Class D moon, similar to Luna in the Sol system.
Okay.
Incapable of supporting life, and yet it has been hit by a protomatter.
Because why? They're just
perhaps
in their weapons.
We'll have some answers. Let's take a look.
Are you daft? They're testing their weapons. I mean, yeah. That's
another uninhabited moon, but one quite different from the first.
Remember,
what is the pattern?
This makes no sense. There is no tactical pattern to these attacks.
Of course not. They're just testing their weapons.
There must be a reason, though.
Yeah, it's called testing weapons. They're testing it on different...
Let's figure this out quickly before more lives are lost.
Different atmospheres and different types of things because they want to kill people. They probably want to attack the Federation and, you know, they're made up of different class planets, so different class moons tested out. One thing I also remember that just came to me is that the Genesis device used a little bit of proto-matter, didn't it? That they used that in the Genesis device, which actually created life, created plant life, and created a planet out of a nebula, which was weird, but I guess kind of makes sense. Maybe they're, I don't know what they're doing, but proto-matter can be very versatile, I'm guessing.
Scanning. The moon is Class L. I'm picking up some ruins on the surface, some simple life forms. There's evidence of crude attempts at terraforming, but no signs of a protomatter detonation. It looks like there was an attempted settlement on this planet, but the project was abandoned. By the look of these readings, it took place over a century ago.
Okay.
The probe we sent to the planet is active now. It's sending data back to us.
Okay.
I'm detecting incredible levels of radiation, atmospheric pollution, ruins of great cities, and... Oh no. Based on these scans, I believe this... is the planet Kentaur, the original homeworld of my people.
You didn't know that?
There are no signs of protomatter here. It seems Kentaur was rendered incapable of supporting life long ago by the Kentauri.
Yeah, shouldn't you have known that this was like your homeworld? I mean, wouldn't you guys have known where that was located? Just saying. This is a surprise to you? First, I've heard of the Kentauri, by the way.
I can barely believe what I'm seeing. I've always wondered what became of them, and now I know. Most Lucari thought something like this would happen, but some of us hoped they would see reason and overcome it. It saddens me deeply to see otherwise.
Okay.
I suppose you have some questions for me.
Yes, who were the Kentauri?
Once we were all Kentauri. Those who followed the teachings of the scholar Lucar came to be known as Lucari. The Kentauri were obsessed with power and material wealth. Their pursuit of such things was destroying the people and the planet. The Lucari stood against those things, and for that, we paid a terrible price.
Sounds to me almost like in Stargate, if you guys are familiar with Stargate, almost sounds like the Ori and the Altarans. One who was... who turned in one way and one who turned another way off their planet. So these, like the Altarans, left their home world to go pursue science or whatever on another planet and left the Kentauri to themselves, whom ended up basically destroying the planet and themselves. But I don't know why the Lucari wouldn't have recognized this planet as theirs. Why would this be a surprise?
I suppose you have some questions for me.
Yeah, why did you leave your home world?
There was a terrible schism between Kentauri and Lucari.
Yep.
It ultimately led to civil war.
Ah, okay.
We lost.
So there was an actual war.
In the final days of the war, most of us chose self-imposed exile over death or imprisonment. We gathered on our remaining ships and left Kentaur forever.
Okay.
To this day, that event is known as the Great Exodus.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, this is a very, very cliche science thing, or space thing, or sci-fi thing, I should say. not uncommon. You know, you've got a species on a planet, they kind of divide, a civil war, half of them leave to another planet, pursue other things, blah, blah, blah.
I suppose you have some questions for me.
Ah, yeah, you seemed surprised to find Kentaur here. Why?
Much about Kentaur was stricken from our records, including its location.
Okay, that makes sense.
Only a few Lucari know of the homeworld. My crew and I were not among their number until now. It is a shameful matter that many of us would like to forget.
However, maybe you should remember, because you learn from you can learn from your past, right? You have to know your past and the truths of your past to learn from your mistakes. So, you know, maybe they should teach about Kentaur in their schools or whatever.
I suppose you have some questions for me.
All right, we should continue on our mission. The Lucari have transmitted the coordinates to the next system for investigation. We're ready. All right, warp out. Well, that was cool. We learned a lot about the Lucari right there. The Lucari came from Kentaur. There was the Kentauri, now the Lucari. It all makes sense. All right, I'm reading the protomatter signatures detected by the Lucari. Preliminary scans indicate the event occurred within the last 24 hours. General Roddick is hailing us. I wonder what planet we're at now. It didn't say, did it?
There has been a large-scale battle in this system. We are analyzing the debris. It appears the losing side possessed technology roughly a century behind our own. Preliminary scans indicate that the battle was very one-sided. I recommend we take a closer look at some of the nearby debris.
Huh, but it didn't say what planet we were at, or did it? I don't know. okay. Oh, we're in the Mivic system. Whoever that is. Never heard of that either.
Our scans are showing the wreckage of dozens of ships. They weren't all military either. I'm seeing remains of freighters, mining ships, research craft, even luxury vessels.
Was this the Zenkethi?
Unclear at the moment. We have not detected any Zenkethi debris in the field yet. Whoever did this was powerful, but not honorable. There is no honor in attacking the weak. I'm detecting strong energy signatures ahead. Further scans may prove to be more conclusive.
Okay.
Around 50 ships were involved in the battle. Many were lightly armed, if at all. I am reading traces of engine-grade plasma ahead. It does not match that left by the local craft. Perhaps the aliens managed to score a hit to the engines of an enemy ship. I suggest we advance and investigate further.
Okay.
This is all that is left of a Zenkethi vessel. It appears the aliens detonated the warp core of one of their capital ships after ramming the Zenkethi at full impulse. They fought with honor. For them, it was a good day to die.
Tell me more about the Zenkethi.
They are reptilian, territorial, and aggressive. In battle, they are ruthless and devious. If they fought with honor, they would almost be respectable warriors. They fought the Empire and the Federation and lost. It appears they are preparing for another war. But with whom? I dislike riddles. Let us get to the truth of these attacks. Perhaps they are testing the weapon against planets that are not part of the Alliance, hoping that we will turn a blind eye to their crimes. Once they have perfected the weapon, they will certainly use it on their old enemies. And their list of enemies is long. We should continue our investigation. There may be more clues in this area.
Okay.
I'm receiving a distress call. It's very faint.
I don't know who you are or where you came from, but thank you.
Okay, alien captain, what happened here?
What can I tell you?
Well, who are you, Verse?
Egan Burren, captain of the Pavini starship Bastion. Or what's left of her, anyway. Most of my crew was planetside on shore leave when the invaders warped into the system. We went into battle with a skeleton crew. It's a miracle we survived. What can I tell you?
Why did the Zinkethi attack you?
I honestly have no idea. Until today, we had never seen them. We hailed them. They didn't answer, and then they started shooting. They just kept firing, even when we tried to surrender. And then some sort of energy bomb went off on the homeworld.
Uh-oh.
It killed everyone. They finished off the rest of our ships and left. Somehow they missed us.
So they destroyed their entire planet.
What can I tell? No, we had no colonies, no allies from other worlds. Until today, we were our own worst enemies. The powers that be on Povan fought amongst themselves from time to time, and everyone thought we were one step away from a global war. In the end, we put all of that behind us to fight these aliens as one. And we still lost. What can I tell you? There might be survival pods from other ships out there among the wreckage. Could you look for them? We're doing all we can to keep life support running over here. I can't start a search and rescue operation on my own. If you have any engineers you could loan or some spare parts, my crew and I would be forever grateful.
Our engineers will assist you while we search for survivors. Okay, recover the life pods.
Thank you, whoever you are, thank you.
Oop, I flew right past him. It's hard to see them. There they are.
I thought no one would come. Thank you, strangers. Thank you.
Someone heard. By all the gods, someone heard the signal. I'm saved.
Thank you again. May we seek asylum among your kind? Please, we don't have anywhere else to go.
We're sending you the location of Starbase K-13. It's not far from here.
I've confirmed the captain's story. The planet nearby was hit by a protomatter blast. Estimated casualties in the... Check your long-range sensors. It just happened again. Another detonation.
Confirmed. Go to red alert.
It is time for a reckoning. The Zinkethi must pay for their crimes. We must go now before they escape.
Oh, here we go, guys. We're going to fight the Zinkethi for the first time. Let's see what they're made of. I'm very excited to find this out. How's this battle going to go? Am I well equipped? I don't know. Now entering the Jod core system, sensors indicate the presence of pre-industrial civilization on the planet. Its moon shows signs of recent protomatter detonation. Zinkethi life signs on the planet.
Whatever the Zinkethi are doing down there, we need to stop it. Now.
Tactical advice.
Target their cruisers first, if possible. The support they provide to their allies is difficult to deal with as long as they are active. Now is not the time to sit and choose whatever okay. This encounter.
So cruisers first is what it's telling me. Look at this. It's like a straight rectangle.
Zinkethi warships!
Wasn't I already warped in?
Alliance vessels, this system has been claimed by the Zinkethi Coalition. Your presence is unnecessary. Leave at once.
Hmm. That's not going to happen.
You were warned. So be it. We now walk on the path of violence.
Battle stations.
Battle, come on. Fight well. Do not fear death.
Ships in cover type, we will fight to win.
Well, that went down fast.
Ships quiet. Strong. Target shield. But we will be strong.
We did quite well in the first battle.
Well,
a good battle. Well fought. The honor of victory is ours.
That was not very difficult at all. I thought it was going to be a lot tougher than that. I didn't even use all my powers. Well, that wasn't much. They really built the Zenkethi up as like some kind of, you know, hard foe, but that was not a hard foe. Maybe they'll be more tough in the STFs. I mean, this is just mission content, which typically is a lot easier. We shall see. Okay, we're going down to the planet. Guess we're going to battle them on the ground now. That'll be interesting. I believe the Zenkethi are using some type of jamming technology to conceal the protomatter bomb from us. Finding it could be difficult in this terrain. Recommendations?
Their weapon is inefficiently shielded. It leaks kaons at a level our tricorders can detect and track.
Kaons?
I recommend we scan for elevated kaon levels and follow the signal.
Sure, kaons. Okay.
The kaon particle traces lead into the valley ahead of us.
Oh, I see. They followed the waterfall.
Who followed the waterfall? We're gonna have to jump? Oh, okay. Goes down. Let's take the side path. Thought those were balloons down there. It's some kind of plant. There are not balloons down here. It's nobody's birthday party.
The rocks here are causing a lot of interference. We should take another set of scans to get our bearings.
Tricorder. What am I bringing up to my ear? Cell phone. Hold. Sun. Rocks. He senses something. Well, that was... Oh, there they are.
The Zenkethi!
And boing.
They're big and angry.
Yeah, I can
do. We now walk the path of violence.
Okay.
So be it. Attack!
Watch my violence. Here we go, everybody. We're fighting Zenkethi on the ground. This is exciting. This is exciting. This is exciting. Where are they?
Come, Zenkethi. See how a true warrior fights.
You will not stop us.
There are some Zenkethi with a taste for battle. Good.
Scans indicate they took the path to the east.
Well, that was kind of easy. I was hoping that would be a little more difficult. I didn't even use all my powers. By the way, I forgot what kit powers I have. I've recently, like, updated my whole kit and everything on my character. So let me just, like, look at this real quick. Let's see what I got here. I've got Phasic Shroud. Okay, that's right. I put that on there. So that's temporary hit points. Dodge, stealth, runs, negative run speed, but I don't need that. Stealth, dodge, okay. Grants perfect shields, reduces damage shields. Okay, so that's that. What else do I have here? I've got mass gravimetric detonation. Creates 3 level 70 gravimetric detonation fields. Does anti-proton damage, that's right. Okay, I got that. Oh, I got the Kligat, don't I? Yeah, I do. So I can throw that for physical damage. I've got the nanoprobe infestation, of course, for my character. That, okay. What's this one? This one is the temporal stasis, stun and damage target over time. Physical damage. And shield 100% shield penetration. Anti-time entanglement field. Okay, that's the one that puts them in a bubble. Also does physical damage and anti-time entanglement. Okay, cool. So that one, I forgot what this one looks like. I think that one just shoots like a bolt at them and does that stuff, physical damage. That's the bubble. This is a Kligat for physical damage. I'll throw it and I'll show you what that does. It's pretty cool. I've got the gravimetric detonations for damage, and then to help to hit point myself up, I got the phasic shroud. Okay.
Why would they destroy entire planets?
Well, because
they must find some tactical advantage in these actions for some reason.
Some reason.
I'm reading Zanketti life signs ahead. They are waiting for us.
Ah, good. We will meet them in glorious battle.
Okay, let's throw a Kligat. I'll show you that. Watch this. Bam! There's the gravimetric detonations. Isn't that cool? Haha! Did a lot of damage to them. Let's throw that. Yeah, there we go. A little phasic shroud going on. A Kligat. Bam, he's down. Ow. Ow. Kligat!
They are using delaying tactics. We must be getting close.
The path continues down from here. The protomatter bomb is still ahead of us.
Okay. Continue towards bomb. Check out those sun rays, the lens flares. The lens flares. The future is bright after all. Who knew? J.J. Abrams knew.
The Kaon levels are rising. We're getting closer to the protomatter bomb.
Yeah, that mass gravimetric detonation is so cool. What it does is it opens Iconian gateways and then does anti-proton damage to them. It's really cool. I mean, it looks cool. Like when you have a whole lot of them.
Enemy targets on sensors.
Stop them! This world must be cleansed!
Shield losing power. Flanking damage detected.
Ha! They fight like cornered rabbit dogs. I can smell their fear.
There, just ahead. I see guards. We must be close.
There we go. One of them and one of them. And a Kligat. And they're gone. Man, I love these powers I've got. These temporal powers and these new kit consoles I put on here.
The trail ends here. I'm reading Zanketti life signs inside that blocked-off cave.
Blasting through all that rock will take time.
I'm reading a tunnel behind that waterfall. One that leads to the cave. We must move. Quickly. Move swiftly. And we can take them by surprise.
I'll show you all the kit modules I have at the end here. I'll show you each one, because they're really cool. Uh-oh. Looks like we got a puzzle coming up here, maybe.
Look! They've set up the protomatter bomb in here! But we'll need to clear the Zanketti from the cave before we can do anything about the bomb.
Okay.
They only left a few guards. They clearly did not notice this entrance.
Enemy targets on sensors.
Did I get them all? No. Now I did. Okay, that wasn't too bad.
Oh my. That is a huge protomatter matrix. It's controlled by three regulator consoles, all active and cycling towards detonation. I can shut it down, but I need time. Cover me while I work.
Oh, okay.
Morzin Kefi, defend the Lakari!
Shutting down Pylon Alpha.
For honor! For the Empire! Your path of violence ends here, Sith Captain.
Flanking damage detected.
Soon, victory will be ours. Keep fighting!
Shutting down Pylon Beta now.
Flanking damage detected.
Beta is shut down. Pylon Gamma is down. We're all clear.
Yay, I'm a reptilian raider. Cool. That was fun.
It's done. All the bombs are deactivated. We can... Wait. Look! These crystal formations are... very similar to those we found at the first proto-bombing site on Draconis 3. This can't be a coincidence. We may have found what the Zenkethi are targeting in these attacks.
They're targeting crystals? What?
Word from the core. Zenkethi ships are dropping out of war.
All right, now we're gonna take this to space. That was a very fun ground battle. I really enjoyed that. Didn't die once. That was a lot of fun. Okay, let's do this in space now.
Alliance vessels! I am Fleet Admiral Aaron Zenzarak. As you now know, this system has been claimed by the Zenkethi Coalition. Further aggression on your part will not be tolerated. This world is not yours to defend. Leave now, while you're still.
We do not recognize your claims, Zenkethi. Your forces have murdered millions. If you are the leader here, it is you who will answer for these crimes.
Then your choice is made. The path of violence. It is one I have walked many times, without fear, without remorse.
You're the violent
Come,
ones.
Let us walk it together.
Okay.
Fight now! For honor and glory!
Warning, ship is under attack.
Have one of them.
Right shield failing.
Okay, there you go. Dead.
This is far from over. Tell your leaders, the Zenkethi will not be denied. Those who try to stop us will be purged, their homeworlds cleansed. You have been warned. Test us at your peril.
Okay.
Let them flee. Let them run to their masters and whimper like craven targs. Let them whisper of warriors who fight with honor and without fear.
I doubt we've seen the last of them.
You may be right. They may return and bring their protomatter weapon with them. Should that day come, I hope to meet them in battle once more with a warrior like you at my side. But for now, I must return to the Empire. There is a matter of great importance that I must investigate there.
Oh, really? Okay.
I think we've found a big piece of the puzzle. I believe the Zenkethi are targeting planets with concentrations of those strange crystals. But why?
They really have it up for crystals.
A riddle for another day, I suppose. For now...
Or another mission
return
episode.
Return and share what we've learned. About everything. Including the fate of Kentaur. Do you think they managed to survive somehow?
Perhaps. Maybe they're in some other colonies, just like you guys fled. Maybe they fled. Okay, let's not leave the system just yet, because we got many things to talk about. First thing that comes to my mind is this. That was actually a pretty intense battle there with the commander's ship. I was noticing that at first, it didn't look like I was doing as much damage as I thought I was going to be doing to his ship. Which just simply means they've given him a very high hull strength, his commanding ship. I did not check the hull strength on it, but when I play this again, I will look at the hull strength and see what it is. Basically, they've just made him into a very, very, very good tank in PvE, as far as PvE content goes. He's a tank there and can just absorb damage. Now, that said... Once I got past his defenses and my sciency powers started kicking in, and my gravity wells and my Tychon's Rift, my drains and my tachyon beams, and then my temporal powers also eating away at him, and then this one, which is a really cool power, it's the nanoprobe contagion field, but it takes a while to build up and do a lot of damage and stuff. Once all that stuff started working for me on my sciency powers, it did wear him down really fast. And there at the end, you saw I took him down actually rather quickly once I got past his defenses. So it tells me and shows me I do have a very powerful science build on this ship. It's a very good ship. It also tells me that there may be some people out there when they play this mission that actually have trouble with that battle. You may end up, if you have a weaker build or a lesser ship, or maybe you don't have, you know, everything at like epic like I do, and you know, you've just got normal stuff, normal quality stuff, or you know, you only have a tier 5 ship or a tier 5 U ship, whatever. Some people may have problems with that battle, or you may blow up a few times before you finally manage to win. It may take a while to wear him down, especially if you're low DPS. DPS matters, like it or not. It is a part of the game, and higher DPS will wear down a character like that, a ship like that, a lot faster than not a lot of DPS. So if you're doing like under 10k DPS, you know, you're doing 2 to 5k DPS or something like that, this is going to take you a while to do that battle. But if you've got a good thing, I think I'm at like 30 DPS on this ship or something, I don't know. If you are of good DPS, then you should be able to handle that no problem. Unless you're like a real papery thin kind of escort and you blow up a few times in the process of it, but that's okay. So yeah, that was interesting. I can't wait to see how all my other ships behave with that battle. That will be interesting. Second thing I want to say, the ground battle was a lot of fun. I really, really enjoyed the constant, you know, throwing Zenkethi at you at the end there on the ground. That was a lot of fun. That also tests your character, tests your ground powers, tests your bridge officers. You know, it actually makes bridge officers useful. And I don't like those missions where they send us and you only get to take like one bridge officer with you. That's stupid. I love it when you get to take all of your bridge officers with you and they actually serve a purpose because you need them. And on this mission, you needed them in that battle. That was important. And that was good. That was a good test, and I enjoyed that, and I want more of that. I want, you know, this was just a good space battle and ground battle mission, and I like that. That's sometimes they get a little story heavy, and they forget that we just, you know, this is a game, and you've got to have some action too. And I enjoyed that, this mission. That was a lot of fun. The last mission, for example, Echoes of Light, was a whole lot of scanning, And there was a good mystery in it, but there was just a whole lot of, like, doing things, but not necessarily combat. This one is all about the combat, and I like that they mix it up like that. So that was good here. Now, the storyline. Why do the Zinkethi want these crystals? What's special about these crystals? So that those crystals is what was in the Echoes of Light mission on that planet 20 Draconis. I'm wondering why those people were growing or worshipping crystals, why the Zinkethi are destroying planets with those crystals. What's the importance there? What's the connection? There's obviously something there. It's a mystery. I can't wait to find out. What else do we have? Roddick mentioned something interesting. He's going to the Klingon homeworld because he has to deal with a matter. What matter is he having to deal with on Kronos? What's going on there? What's happening? Something with the Klingons is going on? Interesting. Maybe we'll learn about that in future missions. Maybe that's part of the storyline. And also, apparently, they're bringing in the Kentauri, the other side of the Lucari, the branch that stayed on the planet and devastated it or whatever. This is obviously going to play a role as well. Maybe later in missions we'll meet up with the Kentauri and we'll see the Lucari and the Kentauri come together. Maybe it will take all of them to take out the Zinkethi. You know, that could be interesting. So there's a lot of story threads that they're pulling here, and I like that. And there's this mystery, and I like that. I don't know what's going to happen. I can't predict what's going to happen. Like, the only thing I can pretty much predict is that in the end we'll probably win. Somehow we'll take out the Zinkethi and we'll win. But how we do that will be interesting. How all that comes to pass will be interesting. So I really enjoyed this mission for all of that. It's opening a storyline, and like they said, they got it planned through 2017 and then into 2018. And they've opened up this whole new part of space here in the Alpha Quadrant, all these new systems that they're going to attach missions to. So you can see they've planned to open this up even more. And that's awesome. It shows that it's growing. The game is continuing to grow after 7 years. And hallelujah for that. Let's exit the system here.
Let them. You may be right.
I think we've...
And get our reward. And we'll look at that. I've got this weird bug, it does this, but it's like a slow warp out. It's like at the end of missions there, while I exit, it does like a slow warp out. Anyway, alright, let's contact command, get our stuff.
So it's true. The Zinkethi have a protomatter bomb. All those lives. No one in the Alliance is comfortable with the Zinkethi having a weapon of genocide. What happened to those planets could happen to any world in Alliance space. We need to know more about it and how to stop it. We need to know more about these crystals you mentioned as well. If they're the key to these attacks, we need to know why.
Okay, so we're going to get the Harbinger title. We're going to get the weekly reward automatically. We're going to get 400 prize vouchers automatically. Our choice today is either a phaser relay, which will not help me at all, or the unique Braden reconnaissance deflector array. Obviously, that's what I'm taking. Collect reward. Look at all the goodies. Look at all that. So, here is the featured episode weekly reward. I'll choose probably a spec point on that, but that's that. 400 prize vouchers to add to my thing. And here's the reconnaissance deflector dish. So let's look at this. This gives us improved shield hit points, so a higher shield capacity. Improve control effects or resistance to the same. Now, control effects, obviously. Oh, and drain. It improves energy and shield drains, too. So this is more of a science-y type of shield here. Not shield, deflector, excuse me. More of a science-y build. And then improves detection of cloaked ships. That's never been useful to me, the perception thing. Does the Zinkethi even use cloak? I don't know. So, yeah, that perception stuff has always been weird to me. Like, why do you need to detect cloaked ships? Usually when you're in battle, they're not cloaked. So it's kind of pointless. A pointless ability. But improved control and energy drain and shield drain all points to science for this thing. Which makes sense, because if you're going to get the Lucari science vessel, then it probably makes sense to put this stuff on that science vessel as a themed build. It goes hand in hand with the new ship. That's their thinking here. So it's part of the Braden Reconnaissance Technology set. You need the covariant shield and the impulse engine and the warp core to go with it. There is a warp core. And there's a 2, 3, and 4 piece bonus. You get particle detection, you get engine infusion, and then the advanced Braden cross wiring. So part of a set. I look forward to getting that set, and I will probably put this set on the Lucari ship and see how it works. So the bonus is extra aux power, more aux power setting, and more improved perception about cloaked ships. So maybe the Zenkethi do use cloaked ships, I'm not sure. More engine power, more impulse expertise, and a cooldown on transwarp, so a lot of maneuverability there. Shield loss safeties decreases the lockout to 45 seconds, removes the engine power drain, adds a knockback to affected enemies, and doubles the damage dealt. This basically improves all of the other abilities. Okay, so that's what you're going to get out of this Braden set. I think I'm saying that right. It's B-R-Y-D-O-N. Braden. It's not Braden, it'd be Braden. But I don't know what that means or what that refers to or where that word comes from. It's an interesting word. Never really heard it before. So, yeah, there you go. That set is what you'll want to get and check out. I don't know how good it's going to be or how useful it's going to be, but sounds like it will work well with the Lucari science ship, so I'll try it out anyway. Obviously, I'm going to get all the parts anyway because I've got to try it out. I told you guys I was going to show you the consoles I was using on ground too, or the kit modules. Here's my Kligat. Obviously, this is from K13. That's where you want to get that from. If you want to get a K13 thing, that's a Kligat. It does physical damage. Throw it. It's pretty cool. I also have the mass gravimetric detonation. I love this. This is sets up those Iconian gateway things and does anti-proton damage. I have the anti-time entanglement field. Shrinking AOA damage and slow field, creates a level 70 anti-time entanglement field, does physical damage and 50% shield penetration. I've got the universal module, Phasic Shroud. This one just keeps you alive, you know, it really, really is good. I've been doing a lot of minor instabilities, this really gets really good for that mission. And then I've got, because I'm a science character, I do have a medical tricorder I always like to have just so I can heal myself instantly. But sometimes I'll replace it to test out other things. Other consoles that I'm, or other kit modules I've been meaning to try out before some of these, I have had the Photonic Overload, which I really enjoy. That one also does radiation damage. And it's just radiation damage. No, it's anti-proton. It's anti-proton and radiation damage. I kind of have this anti-proton thing going on where I want to do a lot of anti-proton damage on the ground. So the mass detonation thing, It does anti-proton damage, and then the Photonic Overload also does anti-proton damage, and then I also had the Gravimetric Traps, which also does something, does physical damage, and then I had something else that did anti-proton, I think, somewhere. This one does the neutronic radiation. I've also got some stuff like the Staff of Landru. It's interesting, but I really don't find it that useful. I have the endothermic induction field. This is from like the winter event. I got the endothermic induction field, the cryogenic stasis field, and the cryonic pulse. I tried those out. They're interesting. I don't know that I will use them in an everyday basis, but I'm kind of trying different things out. Metaphasic rejuvenation. I don't think I've tried that out yet. Vodwar shield drone, I have one of those, and the automated adrenal hypo. There's a lot of these I haven't used yet that I'm testing out, but I really like this build right here. This seems to be pretty powerful. I don't know what I would remove, honestly. I like all of them. I really do. I would have to remove this one to try some other things, but yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, you saw me on the ground there. I did pretty well with those modules, so it worked out well. That's my ground setup anyway. But I'll try different things. And I can't wait to try this mission on my other characters. My engineering character and then my tactical character. Because I've got different ships, different ground configurations and everything. It'll be interesting to see how it works versus the Zenkethi, you know, on ground and space. Well, everybody, that is the new mission of Signs and Portents. Gotta say that I actually liked it. It's not too long. and it has good space battle and good ground battle. So I like that. Good mix. Got both. Yeah, it's a good introduction to the Zenkethi. I look forward to the future storylines they're pulling here. Can't wait to see where it's headed. Post your comments below and let me know what you think of this mission. By the way, I will go ahead because I have those 400 vouchers. I will go ahead and add that here because I'm definitely getting this ship. So there go 400 vouchers added to my anniversary event reward ship. Now I just got to play the daily every day for 40 vouchers a day. So there you go. I've got 600 left that I need. I will get there. And we will get that ship. Post your comments below and let me know what you think of this mission after you've played it. Your thoughts, your opinions, how difficult it was or not for you. Looking forward to all that feedback and commentary. Thank you all for watching. This has been a very, very fun featured episode. And stay tuned for the next one.